Romverse, Indiana Jones, Dial of Destiny, from Hasbro Adventure Series Speed Review.
So, another sequel. How's that going?
Same as always.
That bad, huh?
Let's go!
Articulation.
Old Man Indiana Jones, from Indy 5. It's a pretty solid, grumpy Harrison Ford portrait. Same rubber hat that we've gotten before, but it is glued to his head. Looking up, tilts all the way down, for sleepy time action. He, like everyone else, has a single elbow, but this guy has a butterfly joint. For a nice forward back on the shoulder, single little ball joint at the torso, kicks forward, decent side kicks, swivel thigh, single joint knee kick back. Overall, this is a very one-note, brown-clothed figure.
Dude definitely has a theme.
Say, Chewie, thanks for letting me borrow this.
Accessories. He comes with a whip, which, unlike the other figures in this line, has a peg up top, which just plugs into his belt. He also comes with a giant, oversized, stuffed-to-the-gills backpack, his satchel, and an old-timesy flashlight. A wayward son, broken marriage, and a sudden surrogate daughter? Sounds familiar. Helena Shaw, from Dial of Destiny. A pretty decent Phoebe Waller-Bridge likeness. Looks to the side, looks up, looks down, but an over-exaggerated neck, ball joint at the sternum, and same T-pose we've seen before.
Shame about your son.
Aw, get over it. Who would have written such a thing for him to be replaced by a new lead? She got a forward kick. A sidekick as the sidekick. Pretty decent. Single kick back. No butterfly, so she does not clap forward. You sound like a droid I used to know. And here's an interesting thing I noticed about this figure. There's no butterfly joint, but they've got the McFarlane shoulder cup thing going. So you get the rubbery shirt out of the way. And she's got a really nice crossover in the arms. Frees up some articulation in the torso, too. But a little gappy. Solid new custom option. Adventure Girls.
Love the hair. Should dye it pink.
Accessories. She comes with a teeny tiny adventure backpack. And another old-timesy hand torch. Come on, Harrison. You can carry the story, the plot, the characters, the legacy. Easy peasy.
Oh, my back.
Indiana Jones, Hypnotized. From Temple of Doom. Solid likeness overall. The scruff looks a bit odd as a dot pattern. But this figure, for the look and design alone, is going to be a fantastic custom piece. You can use this for so many things. He's got a wide range of movement. Eat your heart out, Jeff Goldblum. Double jointed torso, so major hula hoop action. In fact, he's got a hula hoop across his shoulders. Same pants as the other indie figures. Forward kick, side kick, single kick back.
The paint is spotty though, just a tad down by his shoe.
Was nothing.
Swivel, swivel, swivel.
He's got cut marks on his back, which are easy enough to remove with some isopropyl alcohol. And a nice hand crossover, too, for dual welding options. In fact, you can be as silly as you want with this one.
Hey there. Oh, hey. Wait, what? No.
This isn't a Tumblr fanfic.
Oh my god.
Accessories. He comes with a standard Hot Topic sippy cup. A new satchel that opens up. You can't stick anything in there, though. And a big, long dental toothpick. As an aside, remember when Temple of Doom used to be the, least popular Indiana Jones? Ah, good times. Short round from Temple of Doom. Hasbro is still relatively new, making quality action figures of children. And Short Round is a huge step forward. They give him a soft goods coat, which bunches up in the back, but straightens out well enough and, you know, for a standard mainline release, really ain't bad. Given it's enough movement and motion, come on, Short and Round, let's go! You take off the jacket, he's got a plastic overcoat, ball-jointed shoulders, single-jointed elbows, also not able to clap forward, but a rubbery shirt with a plastic body underneath, ball-joint at the torso waist, moves just as well as you would hope, double-jointed neck, nice kick forward, nice side kick, a hinge at the thigh, hinge and swivel ankle, single joint kick back. The only gripe is how cheap the ankles are, but you know what? I will give them a pass. For a tiny figure that is nothing but articulation, he turned out really well. Keep your dreams alive. Accessories. He comes with his blue jacket, pocket knife, and an overpriced Indiana Jones Hasbro toy. His Yorkless baseball cap, and a standalone Indy fedora cap that
does not fit on Indy. A lit torch to tie to look together. Playing toys, telling stories with Dad or that special person in your life is nothing like it. Thanks, Dad. Indiana Jones from Temple of Doom. Now this look is my preferred look of Indy. Grizzled, battle-worn. He has seen some stuff by this time in the movie. I will give it to Hasbro. Each of these Indiana Jones figures has a unique face and head sculpt. Hat is still glued to the head though. It utilizes the same body as the Hypnotized Indy version with an arm from the standard release. George Lucas sure does like this one very particular look. Same legs as the other Indy legs. Slight battle damage on the leg is the only difference. Doesn't clap forward, but can dual wield a machete. Hey, looking good, Dad. Accessories. He comes with the same coil lasso and belt and holster from the initial release. Comes with an unfurled whip. Comes with a satchel, which we've seen a bunch of times already. The long machete for the bridge sequence. No holster, so you gotta get creative. A teeny tiny pistol, but no pistol finger. So good luck holding on to that. Does fit into the holster. I'm too old and tired for this. You kids got this. The build an artifact skull altar. And snake. It's a nice design, but these three pieces are itty bitty, teeny tiny. So if you have anything larger than little kid child hands, you're probably going to want a tweezer to place these where they need to go. There's a slight indentation to help them stay in place, but good luck with that. May not be a bad idea to put some stick tack on the bottom of these. And as a bonus feature, the orange ones glow in the dark. Night-night, skull statue. Now for the customizers, I don't know why, but each of the Indiana Jones figures has a different sized barbell joint in the neck. So if you wanted a head swap, your mileage is going to vary. It does seem that the hat versions are a bit undersized, and if you wanted a head swap with the Force Awakens Han Solo, you can, and I actually prefer this, because if you are going to drag Harrison Ford and put him in the fedora again, you can at least have a good time doing it. This is an Indiana Jones overload. Three Indies and two side characters. Kind of the McFarlane Batman angle. Hasbro really seems to be just throwing everything out there, expecting the line to get canceled. So when they announce the next wave, they're like, oh, okay. Let's put a couple more out there and expect it to get canceled and see how it goes from there. Will there be peg warmers here? Absolutely. Is there custom potential? Absolutely. But if you're an original fan of the series, it's a solid bang for your buck. Helena. 7. Old Indy. 7. Alter. 8. Short Round. 9. Temple Indy. 7. Hypno Indy. 8.
Out of 10.
They've butchered Harrison Ford characters in two franchises already. Let's see how they do with a third.
This is Rob vs. Toys. Subscribe and we'll see you next time.